Hello guys, welcome to Survival Russia. It's good to be back and posting because it's been a little while since I've been posting. 3-4 days or something. This is a little bit longer than I like, but that is how it goes sometimes. The video here is gonna be about foot wraps. I have done foot wrap videos earlier, but that was the Russian style of foot wraps. Today we're gonna take a look at the more German style of foot wraps. Maybe the Germans also use the Russian variant. I would guess so, I don't know, but this is a different setup and it's for laced boots. It's pretty awesome, but before we start, of course have to be something which has nothing to do with the video. That's how my videos work most of the time, right? I have so much video material that I want to put out, and it's sort of like actually piling up, so yeah, that's always a good thing, right? But yeah, I was buying a Christmas present for Sergei Vyatka Honda, and then I got this weird jacket. I know I have a flaw or soft spot for camouflage, and especially weird camouflage, and then backpacks. So yeah, I ordered this jacket here, and then I also ordered these Czechoslovakian foot wraps. They are square, unlike my Russian ones here, which are rectangular and quite used. But foot wraps are very useful. It's a very, very useful thing to know how to do, and it can also save on your socks and so on. And as I say, these are used especially in laced boots. Some people actually asked me if they could use this variant here, the Russian variant, in laced boots, but these are mostly for jack boots. So to get on topic with the foot wraps theme is that I'd like to show you how they look after I've been walking a few kilometers and so on, and how relatively easily the adjustable it is in the field, and you get used to it and so on, because they're a little bit tricky to get used to. See, they look like this, and underneath they are nice and flat. This fold here, you don't feel it at all whatsoever. And if they need a little bit of adjustment or tension, it's not too complicated. Just grab it. You can, if you need to pull a little bit here and there, just grab it like this, and then you just tie them again. It's not super duper complicated, actually. I have explained the advantages in the Russian foot wrap videos I've made, but I'll do it again. Maybe there'll be some new viewers, right, and you guys who already know this, just sit and take it calm, and we'll get to the point of the video soon. But what the advantage is, of course, that contrary to a sock, you can open this up and hang it on a fire or something close to a fireplace, or a windy summer's day, and they will dry pretty fast. Also, they are really nice with the feet. They do not constrict the feet. They ensure that you have good blood circulation. The advantage of the foot wraps is also that if you are without socks and you have some rags or something with you, you would know how to make an emergency or survival sock, we can say, right? Definitely an emergency sock. These guys here works very well with the laced boots. And talking about laced boots, that makes me realize that I have actually forgotten to bring laced boots with me, so I will go and get them very shortly. Also, my very best friend in Germany, he decided to send me an old Husqvarna chainsaw. That is awesome. That's we're also gonna take a look at. We're gonna head up in the northern part of the forest at some point here. We're gonna head down in the southern part. basically the northern part it's mostly wolf territory, the southern part is mostly bear territory. And at the moment we actually have a crew of a pack of like 6-8 wolves circling up there, so it's very dense forest up there and so on. Just, they are very tricky guys, the wolves. They actually snatch the hunter's dogs while the hunters are out hunting for moose and rabbit and so on. So yeah, but I'll get a set of not a set. I'll just get one laced ankle boot so you can see how this works. So let's see if I can actually manage to do this. So you actually get an idea on how these are made or put on. You can say, if you know how to make the Russian style foot wrap already, then that's a very good thing. It makes it a little bit easier. Here we have a foot with some Finnish boot socks. These are the thin ones. They're awesome. So we put our foot on here, toes to that corner, heel to the other corner, and we start with folding over this little guy here. Then if it's your right foot, you'll start on the left side of your right foot. If it's the left foot, you'll start on the right side of the left foot. But you'll take this guy here and fold it over, kind of like nicely, like that. Then you take the other corner, fold over here. You can pull down a little bit and so on and so forth. Then we have the corner in the back here. This guy here you just pull over like this, pull it tight, and we pull something like this. Then I pull the rear corner here to make it flat down here, right? So I basically just take this little guy here and fold it over here. And I will stuff this little corner down here temporarily. As I said, this can be used with or without socks, but this is a very good way of saving your socks a little bit, or prolonging the life of your socks. We can take our boot here. That is a very well used bait. I think it's a GX4 boot actually. Then we can loosen up this little corner if we want to. We can also just put it back. But basically, when we tie the boot, it will sit there very nicely. So see, I just took my foot out of the ankle boot there, and they pretty much sit like when I made them. But because this is a little bit tricky, I know from previous videos that people are always asking about this and that, so I'll try and do it again from another angle so you can actually get an idea on how to do it. But okay, we take the front corner, fold it over the ankle here, or the wrist it is. And as I said, when it's the right foot, then you start on the left side of the right foot. Fold this guy over here, and you just find some nice place to have it stored over here on the right side of your foot. Then you take the other corner, fold it over your foot. You can hold a little bit in this. You can hold in this corner, you just fold it, right? But yeah, we fold this guy over here. And there's not much to it other than just laying it here. What I did before was that I took this corner here and pulled a little bit to straighten this part here out under the foot. And then I will take this guy here and fold it over like this. It can flap up on it, but that doesn't matter. And then we can take the corner we just folded and stuff down here if we can. Now I unwind it, it's not a big problem, because it's pretty simple to do all this stuff here, like that. we're ready again. Even you might think this is out here on the side of your boot. I cannot feel it. I also on the Russian system, when I use it, the Russian style, it's much thicker and heavier here, but it's actually not a problem whatsoever. Try and put it on again. And just like before, I cannot feel any folds or anything whatsoever. So one of the good things about using foot wraps over socks is that the foot wrap will sort of like attach itself to the sock, and the sock will not slide anywhere. I mean, I have, when I'm wearing jack boots, I don't like socks that much because they will always, you know, travel out onto the forehand of the foot for some weird reason. It's because, of course, the heel is working up and down, and as I said, the Russian system here, which is much bulkier for jack boots, it does not work very well in laced boots. So it's a good way to make an emergency sock, for definite. And it's actually very comfy to use. Basically, this reminds of some polishing rags, you know. This is very old school. I mean, you can use almost anything as long as it's not too heavy. But any type of flannel, any type of mix of cotton and wool, if you can find some thin wool, you can of course also use wool. Cotton is awesome for the summer. This fabric is from the, it's made of cotton, and it reminds a little bit about the fabric that you have in the towel machines, you know. Something like that. That is very good. And for winter you can use some kind of flannel. We have some, in Russia we have some mix called Baika, and it's a mix of 50% cotton and 50% wool. Then you can have winter socks underneath and all that good stuff, and put your foot wraps on top. But yeah, now I'm gonna head out and buy some supplies, some food supplies and stuff for the homestead here. And at some point, maybe during the weekend, maybe during the start of next week, I'm gonna make a video on how to make some awesome salted meat from a recipe of Sergei Vyatka Hunter. Talking about Sergei Vyatka Hunter, he's heading back to the big city today, but I was out making two videos with him for his channel, and whenever they are up, I will link to those videos. It's very, gonna be very, very interesting, especially one of the videos. So guys, please check the links in the description, and subshare and subscribe, sub bell, sub like. Please consider supporting the channel, that will be awesome. Thank you to all you guys who already are supporting the channel. I very much appreciate it. And yeah, get out and train, get it done, do something awesome. Thank you for your time. See you in the next video, guys.